I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady. Hold, hold on, hold on to me, 'cause I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady.
Describe a little bit how it's like to won 3 state championships in a row.
First, I got to give my hats off to the coaching staff. When I first came out, I believe in Coach Ice. You know, he told me, you know, it's going to be a great opportunity for me to win multiple years. And I took his word as a young man. You know, I took his word as a man. And I just went with it. And, I never looked back at it. And all my years have been great winning. And also, I got to give my hats off to Coach Tim Harris Jr. You know, he had took a role in for his dad this year. And also, it felt great. Unbelievable feeling to win 3 state championships back to back in high school, only losing 1 game in your high school career. And it's just something that you're going to look back on and see. You really accomplished a lot of your own goals and dreams. The dreams do come true as a young guy.
And now it's Mark Walton's turn to try to show some skills. Mark Walton, the junior running back for Booker T. Washington, going the distance. Touchdown.
You know, they don't come around often. And, you know, the impact that he had on my coaching career is big, especially being in his first year as a head coach and him, you know, in his senior year, really leading our team, going getting through 15-0, it's really standing up for us in all of the big games. And, you know, he was kind of a common factor for me. You know, whenever times got tough, he always let me know, hey, coach, man, I got you. You can give it to me. I got it. I'm going to make it work. And, you know, Mar Walton, I'm going to miss him. Mar Walton just when you look at his body of work through his time here at Booker T, you know, he helped us get to this point, you know, where we're a national, you know, elite program. I watched his growth from when he came in the spring of his 8th grade year, you know, up to now. You just see the development year after year for the guy. And, you know, not just talking about from a football standpoint, but the way that he carries himself in the business, in the classroom. You know, I had an opportunity to work with him as a student of mine in the classroom as well. And you just see the vision of where he wanted to really make it in life. And, you know, being able to work with him on both sides from an academic standpoint and on the football field, it's been a tremendous time for me as a coach.
Hold on, hold on to me, 'cause I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady.
Everyone knows Mark Walton on the football field. I mean, everyone across the nation knows you're one of the baddest dudes on the gridiron. Mm-hmm. Tell me a little bit, who's Mark Walton off the field like?
A funny guy. I like to have fun with my friends, you know. Outside of football, you know, I like to listen to music, hang out with my family. I'm a family person, you know. I like to be with my family, see my family smiling. I don't like to see nobody down. You know, I'm just Mar Walton. I like to have fun and be happy.
What about that day, man? Take care of you. You got a lot left to come, man.
You don't want to be on the camera.
One thing, a lot to come on, man.
That's Terry Jefferson, man.
Club. They call me Club for one reason. You know what that means. Okay. Plug him up.
What that
means?
Tell him what that
means.
That means
he got a little six. I call him Plug. He love to plug the hole. And he never fails. He gonna plug it. Plug.
Hey, Plug. He got it.
It's my reason, Alexander. Hey, a lot of people sleep on this cat. Love this, man. One of the best quarterbacks that's come out here, man. Come out of Dade County, period.
Things, man.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, Devontae Davis over there, Texas too, bitch. Whoa. Like, come on, small, they call, we call him Peanut Man. That's why we call him Peanut Man. That's why we call him Peanut Man.
What's up, y'all? We both know actions speak louder than words.
Right.
You know, we make a mistake, we'll go talk about it, have a conversation. We'll apologize for what we done. Mm-hmm. And go ahead and try to make things right no matter what the situation is. If we don't understand, we don't ask. How can we handle different things? And, you know, try to be the best we can be.
Right.
Coach B right here, yeah, me and Coach B. Me and Coach B.
Florida State alumni. One of the biggest fans out here. No blood. You see this right here? He got on nose right now. Every, I tell him, every empire you got a phone. Mortgages, we smash one game. Or every empire you got a phone, and y'all felt that week. Okay. Morgan handle job, man.
Make sure your empire.
We're going to rebuild. Every empire got to rebuild, too.
That's cool. That's
in rebuilding mode.
No blood.
Uh-huh. Mine is blood.
I mean, how happy are you to be able to just really represent your city and kind of hopefully put Miami back on the map?
Like I told a lot of people on Twitter, a lot of the fans, I said, this is my town, my city, my home, 305A. No better place to do it in my hometown. I grew up loving the University of Miami, and I got an opportunity to play for them and help bring changes to the university. And that's what I'm here to do. You know, I'm going to go and distribute a lot. I'm going to do whatever I can do. Like I told Coach Coley, I got a winning mentality. I hate to lose. I hate to lose more than I like to win. So
yeah.
I got that mentality in me, and I'm gonna try to bring that to the table over at the University of Miami and try to bring everything back.
Hold up to me, 'cause I'm a little unstable.